Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to set up the ADR recording on the Fairlight page. There's a few things you got to do before you can start recording. First thing on the setup, if we go through, there's record and playback. You can change your pre and post roll. This is where you choose your input device and which track you're going to record to. And this is where you name the track. This is also where you can add a character list. So if you have more than one talent, you can add and name them, and then that'll give you which character you want to choose from. And then there's the count off countdown beeps. So there's beep to endpoint, how long the countdown is, and then some video streamer controls for overlays, which we'll show you. I left everything in default and just changed the pre-roll. So that's the setup tab. And then there's the record tab, which won't have anything in it until you make a cue. So to make a cue, you have to go to list, and you can import a list if you have one already made with this little drop-down menu, import and export, or you can make your own. You can do that with an in and out marker or using the range tool here, and you could slide and choose a range. And then based on those in and out markers, you can hit new cue. It'll populate down here, and this is where you can choose the character name, and this is where you can write the line of dialogue. So now we have a new one, and then to delete any lines, just right-click them and hit delete. So I have two set up here already. Now another important thing is in your media pool, you should make a destination folder, otherwise it'll just go wherever you last have chosen. So I chose VO, and that's where my clips are going to land. Now, the ADR system has that beeping to count you in when you're going to record. And in order to hear that, you have to set up an additional track. So here I made a track audio 3, just a new mono track. And then underneath the track input menu here, open input. From sources, choose system generator. And they have one called beeps. And for the input track, I chose beeps, which I named it beeps. Otherwise, it would say audio 3. And then I patched that. One more step is you need to go to that same menu and go down to path settings and make sure this through button is highlighted, and that will let the signal pass through whenever it needs to play. So now you're set up and you're ready to go. You do have to arm your track for a record. So since we're going to track one, I have that ready to record. It won't actually do that when you go to record on the ADR tab. So we have the list, and if we went through and spotted a whole bunch of lines, we'd be ready to record. So now we're going to go to record, and you can see these are grayed out until we click on one of the cues. We have a couple options under here. There's keep playing and keep recording. Keep recording is going to go past the out point. And in case you flub the line or your timing's off, this is kind of good to have. You are making a new track, so it's okay if it continues to record until you hit stop. And keep playing will just keep playing. We'll choose voice one. Now we have a rehearse function, a play, a stop, and then a record. So let's go ahead and record. And if we watch this floating window here, you'll see the countdown, and then here is the line of dialogue that we need to say. So it'll count you in, beep, and give you a little time indicator on when you're supposed to say this line based on your duration. So let's go ahead and hit record.
Here we have a lone penguin in search of a companion.
Okay, so you could see it kept recording after the line was finished. Here it is now. Take it out of record.
We have a lone penguin in search of a companion.
Now you can do multiple takes on the same channel of audio, much like a regular DAW. So you could leave this as is, click back on the cue, record one more time.
Here we have a lone penguin, in search of a companion.
Now you could hear my voice from the prior take because of the input monitor style was on repro. If we just had it on input or auto or even record, it wouldn't have played that. So now that we recorded two takes, how do we get to them? Underneath view here, down in the middle, you have show audio track layers. Now you can see both takes on that same audio channel. To switch between the two, use your arrow tool, and whatever one's on top is the one you're going to hear. So right now, the second take, which is called VoiceOver 8, is on top. If we want to swap them, click it, drag it, and let go. So if you hit shift and drag, it won't actually go to the left or right like this. You can hold it, hold shift, drag, and it'll swap. So it's kind of like the edit page whatever's on top is what you're going to hear. And if we had trimmed it to there, you would hear this bottom layer until it reached the top clip. So that's how you can switch between takes, and then they're both inside the media bin under VO. So that's how you can record your ADR list and then go to the next one. It'll go to the time code. You can hit that, go to your record, click on it, and rehearse or record again. And that's how you can set up, hear the beeps, do multiple takes inside of Fairlight. All right. Hope that helps. Thanks for watching as always, and I'll see you guys on the next one.